Winds on our planet are created by the difference in temperature between the equatorial regions and the poles. They are the flow of air from high to low pressure. As warm air rises in the tropics, it flows towards the poles, where the air pressure is lower. On its way there, the air cools and sinks again, conversely leading to higher pressure and counterflows near the surface. This way, winds are basically redistributing heat energy over our planet. This process of energy redistribution, combined with the Earth's rotation, generates the weather patterns we experience every day and makes our planet habitable. In August, the European Space Agency will launch its latest Earth Explorer mission, Aeolus. The mission aims to further improve our understanding of winds and help increase the accuracy of weather forecasts. Today, meteorologists have to analyze winds by using weather balloons, tracking clouds, measuring temperature and looking at sea waves for surface winds. These methods, however, have severe limitations and give insufficient data.
All of these systems are not measuring all over the globe at all altitudes from the surface all the way up to the top of the atmosphere. And in order for the model to get the winds right, they need more observations. And this is where the Aeolus satellite will come in. Aeolus will measure winds from the surface or from optically thick clouds all the way up to 30 kilometers and filling a gap in the current observing system of the Earth for forecasts.
To detect these wind profiles from space, Aeolus uses a powerful laser called Aladdin, which stands for Atmospheric Laser Doppler Instrument. This instrument ejects an ultraviolet laser beam through the atmosphere. The air particles in the atmosphere, which are moving because of winds, reflect some of this light back to the spacecraft. By measuring the shifting frequency of this backscatter, Aeolus can detect the wind speed and profiles at different altitudes. Aeolus is the first satellite to use this technology in space. Due to its low altitude, Aeolus will have a lifespan of only 3 years. However, ESA hopes the technology will be continued on similar satellites in the future, as the understanding of wind profiles is a key factor for meteorological and climate models which benefit us all.